The House bill not only seeks to close the so-called gun show loophole, it also seeks to impose background checks on private sales and to force the involvement of licensed dealers in those private sales. And then the second bill seeks to close the Charleston loophole, where people would be able to get the firearm if the background check wasn't finished in 3 days, which is what happened in the mass shooting in Charleston, where if there'd been more time, he might have been denied that. So the House bill seeks to do that, and that's what the conversation is going on in the Senate, where I think there's some objection to including private purchases, but maybe closing the gun show aspect, maybe extending the time a little bit. We'll see. But, you know, one study of gun purchasers found that 22% of gun purchasers did not go through background checks because private sales are so prevalent. And just as a matter of sort of empirical, I'm going to add some nuance to what you say. We don't know how many straw purchases occur. We just know it's hard to find and prove. And that's why you have, as you say, relatively rare that they actually catch somebody and find out that it happened. This is not a cure for anything, but another bit of data that I read, in the past 25 years, 3 million people have been caught in the background check system trying to purchase who should not purchase, because every purchaser is not sophisticated about their prohibition.